Hello there, it's Asia Marquet here, Lemon Creation, and today I'm gonna show you my art journal page, and this is a layout I prepared for Lindy Skunk, and I use their beautiful squirts and also some papers from AB Studio. So today I'm gonna show you a little bit of collaging. I'm gonna be using my art journal, which is not really an art journal, it's just a normal notebook. And because of that, I'm gonna be covering it with gesso. But before, I will add some collaging. So I'm gonna use the papers from AB Studio by Aga Baraniak. And one of them is coming from Flowerful Life. And I'm gonna just put them on the paper. And the three squirts today I'm gonna be using are Putin Gold, Maple Syrup Bronze and Canadian Bacon Blush. I love squirts, and as I told you in the last video, squirts are not exactly similar to sprays. Well, they are similar, they are in liquid form, but they are less fluidy, and that's why they have cups instead of sprayer. So let me continue with my art journaling. What I've done, I use a mud gel to glue the page to the book, to the journal. And now I'm covering everything with a heavy white gesso, which is not really that heavy, so I don't need to dilute it with water. And I wanted to cover a little bit of design, but let them still be visible. And I'm gonna do some stenciling. I put my elements onto the page to see where I want the stenciling to go. And I'm using the stencil from AB Studio and also sandpaste from PBO. I love working with PBO products, they are really lovely. And they are of good quality. And you've seen me contouring a little bit around the flowers here because they are very uneven, so I didn't want the stencil to go where I want to place the flowers later. And once again, the whole idea is to actually have something on the background which is visible, but not very striking. As you can see, I'm working on the covers of my notebook, so there was already some writing, and that's why also I decided to use some paper, some collaging, to kind of even it out the two pages. And after, of course, after doing the stenciling, I'm gonna let it dry, or I'll dry it with a heat gun. You can do whatever you fancy. The first color I'm using on this page is Canadian Bacon Blush, and I have to admit I made an error, I forgot to press record. So I took another piece of paper, I treated with gesso and I did the stenciling, and so like that I can show you the part which I missed or I forgot to record. And it was exactly the part which I wanted you to see, because the squirts are so beautiful. This one in particular, it's pink but it has golden reflex. And it's very easy to apply and it's very nice to work with. So this is the finished page after applying on the first squirt. And now I am working with the second one. That's a Putin Gold. And I want a subtle effect, so I am dabbing off the excess of the paint with a tissue. You can of course leave it like that, so the color will be stronger, but I prefer to do it this way. And even without drying it off, because I dabbed the excess, I'm adding the next squirt, and this one is Maple Syrup Bronze. And what I like also with stenciling, it's the fact that the colors tend to stick to the relief of the stencil, and they stay there a little bit more strong than on the sides. and that gives also an extra effect to it. And as you can see, after drying, they are quite subtle. They are not very strong. Of course, if you want a stronger color, you can reapply them, or you can just simply not dab it off with the tissue. And next thing is to add some stamping. And I'm gonna be adding a little geometrical things to kind of match the stenciling, even though I'm working with flowers. I don't know why I decided that I want some geometry with flowers. Maybe I could have done some flowers with flowers, I've no idea, maybe some circles. But I just had it in mind, I wanted to do that. I love working with geometrical motifs, so here I am. The black archival ink I'm using right now is also quite strong, so it's very visible, which in this case is very good because, as you can see, I decided to have subtle colors, that's why I dabbed them off. And the papers that I'm using from AB Studio, they are also very subtle, they don't have strong colors, so I feel like you need to have some contrast, and that's why I'm adding a little bit of archival ink with stamping. And this is another stamp from Paper Poetry, it's a script stamp. And just before, you've seen me using the stamp from Viva Las Vegas. And so that's basically what I'm doing, I'm adding some stamping, the light is playing tricks on me, as you can see, I'm sorry for that, it's getting a little bit darkish at moments. And this is a die from Fantasy Dies. Also very geometrical, but when I put it first underneath the flowers, when I was trying everything on the page, I very much liked the effect it gave me. And to place the flowers, I'm using simply a tacky glue, because as I said, I don't have any relief underneath them. I left the place where I'm gonna place them without any stenciling. And on the other side, I'm gonna do exactly the same thing. A little bit of fantasy dye and the flower. And the last step would be to add some sentiment. So sentiment for me has to match a little bit the layout of the page, and as you can see, I showed you one sentiment, and finally I actually chose something else. I chose rainbow flowers. And this is it. In this movie I wanted to show you what beautiful subtle effects you can also achieve with Lindy's, and especially with Squirts, which looks to the naked eye as a strong color, but if you want, you can do something very delicate and very elegant with them. And believe me, there is so much golden reflex in this page, I really really love it. I hope you enjoyed that, and I'll hope I see you soon in the next Lindy's tutorial. Meanwhile, have a lovely day, and bye-bye!